Folks representing the advocacy group Stop Solitary CT today outside New Haven Correctional said, look, other states have adopted methods that were alternatives to solitary confinement, and it's about time Connecticut did too.
We're in the front of this battle to stop the torture of our family members behind these bars and so many other bars around this state.
Her son went to prison at the age of 17.
And 20 years later, he still suffers. He's never been the same. We should be ashamed.
Stop Solitary CT says confinement for more than 22 hours a day is simply inhumane.
I have a son that is an inmate in Northern Correctional Center. I have not been able to talk to my son in 2 months.
And she said her son's not even been permitted to so much as send a letter.
My heart is broken. The family has been dismantled.
The Lowenstein Clinic with Yale Law School says across the country, there are alternatives to isolation that actually make prisons safer.
From dispute resolution practices based in restorative justice, diversion units, expanded mental health care.
I started out being incarcerated in this facility at the age of 16.
He says he still suffers the effects of having been diagnosed with post-traumatic stress disorder and manic depression.
There are many days that I'm filled with anxiety and fear in my daily life.
And Stop Solitary CT has brought their message to buses and billboards statewide.
They are now all officially up on I-84 and I-95. We're going to have digital ads.
You can reach out to your local legislator to find out how you can sign up for a public hearing on this matter. That takes place March 22nd. Here in New Haven, Tony Terzi, Fox 61 News.